Welcome to the UTrain Online Summer Series. And what we got for you today is called the Core Inferno. So guess what that means? All core, ladies and gentlemen. So we're breaking it down to three circuits. Three sets of four exercises performed for 45 seconds, 30 seconds, and 15 seconds. And I stand by that. If I go over at a minute, someone please yell at me because you know how I get. So I know everyone thinks abs, right? Everything's on the floor, but today we're starting standing up. So go ahead and bring your fingertips behind your head or at least near your head. Try to keep your chest open here. Don't round the shoulders. And we're going to mimic the pattern of a traditional bicycle crunch here. So what you want to think is opposite elbow to opposite knee. So you're going to pull that belly button and rotate elbow to opposite knee and then switch sides. This is not good posture, right? We want to walk around with confidence, okay? So first exercise, first set, 45 seconds. We are going to start, looking at the timer, in 4, 3, 2, and go. So alternate, take your time here, especially if you're new to this, you've never done this before. Balance, obviously, will be a component here. Draw the navel to spine. Whoops. See, I already fell down. It sounds really promising when the teacher does. Think about rotating around the belly button, not the lower back. So just feel this in the lower back. Readjust your form. Almost there, guys.
To the ground, the more engaged your core will be. Just make sure you can still press that low back into the floor.
3, 2, and 1. Let's bend those knees, bring those knees flat to the floor. We're working into something called penguin heel taps. One of our friends, this is her favorite ab exercise of all time. I think it's because they're penguins. So try to keep the feet hip distance apart if possible. If you can't reach the heel, you can open the feet. That will make it a little bit easier for you. But just like a penguin, let's keep those arms alongside us. Maybe lift those shoulders off the ground. That'll add a little extra here. And we're starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, reach for the heels. Now it's important here that you
go with the lateral movement. This is not a crunch, right? I mean, it kind of is for your obliques, but I really want you to think about crunching on the oblique, not up and down, but side to side. It's lateral. If you find that your neck's a little cranky in this position, you of course can support the head with your hands. Almost there, guys. And other, you can also, my shoulders are lifted for a little bit of extra, but you can lower the shoulders to the ground. Almost there for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Maybe go ahead, bring those knees into your chest, give yourself a nice overhead stretch. That feels good after all that crunching on the abs. And when you're ready, we're gonna pop up to that standing position for our third second round of standing bicycles. And we'll start at 3, 2, 1, go. 30 seconds should feel a little bit more of a breeze compared to the 45 seconds, right? Hopefully. Unless you're like us, who love abs so much and just want to be able to.
If you love them, you can add more time.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You can do some reeking. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's head to the floor for our tall sit-ups.
Push. This is the finish line.
summer, you gotta work for it.
Together and create a longer workout if you have the time to do so. Thanks for joining us. Bye.